Hi friends, I am Rakesh. Today we are going to discuss about Kirchhoff's laws. Kirchhoff's laws are very important in electrical engineering. On these laws only, some other laws like nodal analysis, mesh analysis, all these are derived. Now there are two forms of Kirchhoff's laws. One is called the Kirchhoff's current law. What Kirchhoff's current law states is, Kirchhoff's current law simply states that the algebraic sum of currents entering any node is zero. That is, if you consider this diagram and I am going to mark this node as A, and there are four currents which are either entering or leaving the node. In this, by Kirchhoff's law, what happens is IA plus IB plus of minus IC plus of minus ID. This current ID is assumed to be going out from this node, and if it is away from this node or moving away from this node, I can write it as minus ID entering into the node. Similarly, so I written that, and the algebraic sum of all these is going to be zero according to Kirchhoff's law. So that I can write as IA plus IB will be equal to IC plus ID, which means that the sum of the entering currents, that is here IA and IB are entering and IC and ID are leaving. The sum of entering currents, algebraic sum of entering currents, will be equal to the sum of leaving currents. This is what the Kirchhoff's law. Kirchhoff's law is a statement which proves the conservation of mass. It can be compared to water analogy, as if there are four pipes and one junction is there, there must be any one leaving pipe should be there, so that a water which comes in will go out. This is about the Kirchhoff's current law. And now we will apply Kirchhoff's voltage law. What is Kirchhoff's voltage law? In defining the potential difference between two points, I stated that potential difference between any two points is defined as the amount of energy required to move a unit charge from one point to another point. Here, if you consider, the potential difference between AB is the amount of energy required to move a point charge from A to B. In that, I didn't mention the path it has taken. The charge may either move like this, or either the charge may move in this format. Like this it can move, but it takes same amount of energy to move from this path or this path. This is stated by Kirchhoff's voltage law. If you consider this diagram, and I am going to move a unit charge from point A to point B through this V1, then the amount of energy needed to move this A to B is V1 volts. That is, since the voltage across A and B will be V1, the amount of energy needed to move unit charge from A to B is V1. And that should be equal to the amount of energy needed to move a unit charge from point A to B through V2 and V3. That is given by V2 minus V3. That is the amount of energy needed to move a unit charge from point A to point B through V2 and V3 is given by V2 minus V3. By conservation of energy, these two should be equal, so that V1 will be equal to V2 minus V3. This is what the Kirchhoff's voltage law states. And this can be generally written as V1 plus V2 plus V3. Summation of Vn will be equal to 0. And see, there are many ways how the KVL can be applied. Kirchhoff's voltage law can be applied in many ways. And one simple method to apply this law is, start from any point in the circuit or in the circuit, move in the clockwise direction, and if while entering, if negative terminal enters first, then you take it as a negative voltage. And if you apply for this, you are going to see this, that I am written minus V1 here, so that if I am moving from point B, I reach minus terminal first, so I written it as a minus V1, and then I further move here, I got first terminal as a positive, so that I written it as a plus V2, and further I am going to move to v3, so that I am going to write it as a minus v3 because I entered the minus terminal and finally I reach b. If you prefer this method, this is going to avoid errors, so that it is very easy and there will not be any confusions. And these two losses are very important. On these only nodal analysis and mesh analysis are derived, so better learn this. And anything if you want to say, you just put in the comments. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you.